name's Kate Cross and I play cricket for England, Manchester Originals and the North West Thunder.
I was the product of being the youngest child in a family, and my brother was like 9 years older than me, so I think as soon as he had younger siblings it was great for him because he could then have people bowling at him, or he could bowl at people in the garden or get us in goal, whatever it was. And Bobby, the eldest, my eldest brother, Bobby would play down at Haywood, which was kind of our local club, but it was where the family was always associated with. So my uncle Bob had played there, my dad used to play his cricket there. And just all my weekends in summers were down at the cricket club, playing next to the score box. We had a little runway that we made as our wicket, and me and the lads were always playing there.
One of the best summers that I've had playing cricket. I think a lot of that is down to last year we played literally three games because of COVID, or I did personally. So this year to have played nearly 40 fixtures was incredible, but yeah, it just felt like a whirlwind really. We went from international cricket, well, we started with domestic, went to international cricket, and then 100, which was just absolutely fantastic, and then back to international cricket. So it's been non-stop, but it's probably been what the women's game's crying out for.
So this is my dad, David Cross.
Got out across. Oh yes, David Cross.
We were talking this morning about how I turned professional cricketer and how influential it was to have a professional ex-professional footballer as a dad. Do you think that helped influence me to play cricket?
I think there's pros and cons. In many respects, because I had experience of knowing what you would be going through as a young professional sportsman, that would help. But on the other hand, I would know the pitfalls as well that you would have to overcome. You know, it's not all as bright and as sunny as everybody thinks it's going to be. It sounds like a great job, but there's a lot of hard days in there. And I knew that. And because you're my daughter, and every parent who listens to this would understand that you're very protective of your children. So I knew that it wouldn't be easy for you, but the challenge is there, and I knew you wanted to do it.
He's been there, he's been a professional athlete. He knows what it's like, he knows the toll that it takes on you mentally and physically.
Both teams in a big appeal, big appeal. Alex Wharf is persuaded.
I must have known Kate above 20 years now. First came across Kate when she'd be about 12 or 13 as a young tearaway fast bowler, or the potential to be a young tearaway fast bowler. That would have been probably around about 2002, 2003 time. I think it's going to be a really great time for Kate, because I think maturity-wise, cricket maturity and maturity in life, which is also important, she's at an absolute point now where I think she can really go well for the next 4 years or so and have a wonderful international career, because I think she's absolutely at the pinnacle and in the prime of her career. So I think the next 4 years can only be good for Crossy, providing she keeps working hard and working smart.
I think when I've been at my best is when I've had a smile on my face and I've gone back to that little girl in the back garden who, I know I was forced to bowl at my brother, but there was a reason that I wanted to stay out there and play cricket with my family and go down to the cricket club. And it was because I love the game so much. And I think when I've put too much pressure on myself to perform is when I've not performed, when I've gone out there to enjoy myself and then, you know, taking the experience of playing in front of crowds here at Old Trafford, that's when I've been at my best.